Hello, this video is going to talk about lab 7 on algorithm analysis. Now, what you're basically doing for this lab is you're looking at 5 different methods which are written in Java and doing big O analysis on them. So you're not writing any code or fixing any code or turning in code this time. Instead, you're just going to basically give me answers to the question of what is the analysis for these 5 methods. Now, when you're doing this, you can use any skills that you want to answer these questions. You can do the methods that we talked about in class where you either go kind of in detail and count the number of steps as a function of n and then simplify it using the rules of Big O. Or if you've developed some of the intuition that I talked about, like seeing, oh, this loops n times, therefore, and it does a constant amount of work for each iteration, therefore it's Big O of n, that kind of thinking would make sense too. For some of the trickier ones, I would also recommend running the programs, running the method to see how it works, especially the last one, number 5. So let's go ahead and look at them real quick just to, in case I have anything to add for those. All right, so when you're doing this, you should answer the question, not only what is the Big O complexity, but also give a short justification, explain why you think that the Big O complexity is what you say it is. And it, as part of that, you should say what n is. Is n the size of the array? Is n the number of integers that are passed in? You know, what is n? All right, so the first one is here. It's this method called exists that checks whether this number exists in this array or not. And you can read through the code to see how it does that. The second one compares 2 throws of rock, paper, scissors. So like one throw might be rock and the other one could be scissors. And in that case, it should say that player one won. And so you can read through to think about that one. The next one is a method called mode. And if you remember, the mode of a set of numbers is the one that it appears the most times. And so this method figures that out. It goes through the array, scanning through a couple of ways to see what is the number that appeared the most number of times in there and returns that. Number 4 is this method that checks if a number is prime or not. So most of these other ones have dealt with arrays in some way. This one doesn't deal with an array. It deals with just a single integer being passed in, but it still does some looping. So you need to sort of use your reasoning skills and think about what is n in this case. It might be a little bit of a giveaway because I called it n. And think about what the Big O of it is. How does it scale as n gets bigger? That's also true for number 5 here, which is going to be a little bit tricky, but I hope that you will use your reasoning skills and hopefully arrive at the right conclusion for this. This method gives you all of the possible numeric codes of a given number of digits. So like if you pass in 3 here, it'll give you like 000, 001, 010, all the way up through 999. If you give it 10, it'll give you all of the 10-digit codes, printing them out as it goes. And so this one I think is not going to be as straightforward, but I think this is one where you would benefit from actually, you know, putting this method into a Java IDE or compiler and actually running it and see what it does. Give it a few numbers and see how it scales up. Does it scale up linearly? Like if you double n, does it give you twice as many codes? Does it give more than that? Use your reasoning skills and especially your like math 284, or rather computer science 284, discrete math, reasoning skills, combinatorics, all that stuff to try to figure this one out. Like I said, this one is tricky, but I hope you figure it out too. For this assignment, when you're done, you should submit it in Canvas. You can either write it directly as text into the like Canvas text entry box, or you can attach it as like a PDF or whatever as an attachment for the assignment too. Like usual, if you're stuck on anything, please let me know. Otherwise, I'll see you next time. Thank you.